r/AskReddit. You're a reverse robber. You break into people's home and leave stuff to confuse families. What things do you leave? Hey guys and gals. Giveaways will be coming soon. So stay notified by subscribing. Share your stories in the comment section. I would love to hear them. Now, on with the video. Someone broke into my garage once. Didn't take any of my good tools. Or anything at all. Left a decent flashlight. I was pretty confused. Probably drunk. My cooking pots once cloned themselves. When we once had one of each type, we suddenly had two identical pots of each. Turns out my in-laws got new pots and decided to give us their old ones by secretly leaving them in our cupboard. That was really confusing. I prefer the version where you just never find out where they came from. A remote control. I think it would be similarly humorous to install a new light switch. Put it in such an inconspicuous place that they would be asking themselves, has that switch always been there? But then they would shrug and laugh quietly to themselves. Because of course it's always been there. Light switches don't just pop up out of nowhere. And then they'd forever wonder what the hell it does. Which is of course, absolutely nothing. I would leave really nice but also creepy notes on their dinner table. Something like, you did great today. Keep it up. You never know who's watching. Write double quotation mark. This isn't the same because they actually took stuff. But the note was affectionate. My old coworker actually had nosy neighbors call the cops on him once when he went to a house to do some electrical. Customer gave him a lockbox code, so he let himself in. He was on his third trip bringing materials in when the cops showed up. While one looked over his invoice and tried to get in touch with the customer, the other kept asking him what he took from the house. And my coworker just said, I must be the absolute worst thief because I just hauled about $2,000 worth of materials inside. Double quote. The cops couldn't get in touch with the customer, so they hung around for a while. Dude just got to work and they left. TLDR. My coworker reversed burgled a new electrical panel. This happened to me once when I accidentally tripped an alarm that was supposed to be turned off for me and the homeowner wouldn't answer the phone. Cops showed up about 10 minutes later to find me up on a ladder on the side of the house with alarms blaring all over, mounting and wiring new security cameras. They pretty much just had a laugh about it and checked my ID just in case and then left me alone to work. A single Vaseline covered watermelon in the bathtub. The imagery of that situation is immensely funny. Chargers that don't match any of their electronics. First gen mini USB chargers. Not microSD like everything takes, no. Mini USB. Just a little too big to fit anything. Each house would get a second-hand self-help book left on the back of the toilet. Everyone would think a different family member did it. That they'd read it themselves and felt they needed to give it to said person. Even if they lived alone, they'd think family or friends snuck in. They'd be wondering why no one said anything directly but feel too uncomfortable to ask. You could destroy entire families with just this. A little mint on their pillows. Little pillows on their pillows. A single egg on a table. Painted gold. So they'll start looking for the goose. Right. I'd place Tupperware in random parts of the house. But none of the lids match the tubs. Light bright. And everyone gets a different picture. Reverse rob me please. Stuff I stole from the previous house. You never run out of items. Neighborhood riots begin to break out as people notice neighbors and friends with their stolen goods. People stop trusting each other. The whole town slowly becomes just a bunch of people who won't talk to each other. Pennies. Just get thousands of pennies and hide them all around the house. They open a container in the fridge and find pennies. They look under their pillow and find pennies. They find pennies in their shoes. The possibilities are endless. They look in their change bag. Pennies. They look in their bank account. Pennies. I try to find out what sports teams they are a fan of. Whatever it is. I place jerseys of their rival team in their closets. What if they don't do sports? Replace one photo in each room with a picture of Danny DeVito. You're really just improving the house at this point. Little rubber ducks hidden all over the place. Break in every couple of weeks and add more. Watch as the family descends into insanity because they can't figure out where all the ducks are coming from. I wanted to mail my sister rubber ducks randomly over the years. I still might do it. Put beer in the fridge. Replace all the fire alarm batteries. And replace all the light bulbs with energy efficient fluorescent bulbs. Everyone else had some messed up stuff. But I like yours because a reverse robber would make something better. Good on you. I'd fold all their laundry and put all the dirty dishes away. That way when they get home they think their spouse or roommate did it and would be in a better mood. Identical couches. But they'd be brand new straight from the store. Nowhere. New smell. Bright new colors. Mind FK. I'm curious to see how someone sneaks around carrying a couple of couches. Leave them an entire Christmas tree. Put presents under it. And leave some half-eaten milk and cookies. In February. With a note that says, "Sorry. Ho ho ho. I was a bit delayed. Oh ho ho ho. Hope you enjoy a late. Ho ho ho. Christmas. Ho ho ho. Don't forget to pay your taxes." My children. Damn you. You made me spit out my tea in laughter. If I'm being an ass, I'd leave another woman's jewelry or something in the master bedroom. If I'm being helpful, I'd want to be year-round Santa. Little Timmy's been wanting a bike. What? The family woke up to a new bike in the living room with a fancy-ass bow on it. Been craving some pizza lately? What? Who put the DiGiannius in the oven? Ding dong. Who's there? There's a delivery guy with a large Supreme with a 2-liter Coke. Been struggling to pay the bills? Why is there 10k in cash inside a man's mouth in the freezer with a note attached on careful disposal instructions? Edit. A word. That escalated quickly. Single socks in every single drawer. What about the drawers that aren't single? If they own a cat, I am shitting in the litter box. If they don't have a cat, bring them a litter box for you to poop into. They'll love the surprise. A single chip. Just one potato chip right smack in the center taped to the TV. Let them be confused. What flavor? Here's a few ideas. Swap which side their door hinges are on so they swing the other way. On any switch panel that has multiple switches, switch around the wiring so switches control different lights. Swap all their lights in each room to be a few steps brighter or dimmer than what they have. Make sure some there's variety. Dimmer rooms and brighter rooms. Number 2. Flips the switch to on and the toilet flushes. So this is gonna get buried cause I'm late, but it's called the leaving. You need someone with a house who's going away for at least a day or two in the fall. A shit ton of leaves. Key to their house or away in. So you rake up all the leaves you can. You get in their house and you hide them everywhere. Not like dump a bag of leaves on their floor. Like hide them shits good. Like behind photos in the frame. In their DVD player and cases. Open up their pillows and stuff them with leaves. Freeze leaves in a block of ice in their freezer. Press leaves between the pages of their books. When they arrive home everything appears normal. Then one of them sits on the sofa. Crunch. Go to turn on the ceiling fan. It's raining leaves. Need something out of the closet? Leaf a lounge. Want to get out of the house that's full of leaves? There's leaves in your shoes and coat pockets. What's this? Your son's favorite stuffed animal is full of leaves. Central air con vents leaves. Junk drawer leaves. Inside your acoustic guitar? More leaves. Someone opened up your cereal boxes and stuffed leaves between the box and bag. There would be the initial confusion and anger. Then after a few days they'd have found most of the obvious leaves. But for the rest of that month probably every day they'd find a lone leaf straggler here or there. Leaves taunting them occasionally for the rest of the year. Years later they'd be pulling an old family photo album off the bookshelf and find a fucking leaf and lose their shit. Maybe you're dead by then. Maybe they eventually found out it was you. Maybe not. All they can do is live what life you've left them. Amongst the leaves. This probably the best response on the thread. I would put an extra key on the key ring and an extra key in the junk drawer. Did you break into my house? Post-it notes on dirty objects that say clean me. Oh boy. That's a lot of work if you reverse burgle me. Bring lots of post-its and pens. A bag of dog food, a bag of treats and a dog toy with a note that says you should get a shelter dog today. This post made me happy. Thank you. Thanks for watching, boys and girls. Tell me your story in the comments. Make sure to subscribe for future giveaways.